What's up, guys? If you're a helicopter fan and building models, if you build models and you're a helicopter fan, you might want to click out of this video real quick. This was the Rebel H-64 Apache. Was. But, you know, this is one of my first models that I did, so I wasn't too good at it. And, well, needless to say, one of the helicopter blades fell off, and I thought it would be very embarrassing to have this beautiful helicopter sitting on the shelf with one blade missing. So I said, you know what? Got out my hobby knife. I got out some pliers and got to work on it. So I modified this into a crashed Apache. This the busted up windshield, got a missing exhaust, the blades are all messed up. Very low. No tail blade, tail rotor, I mean. Flaps are all messed up. And then if we rotate this helicopter, the arms. We got one exhaust there. You know, like I said, the propellers are all messed up. The windshield is still busted. Here's the other side of you with a tail. And it was a really good kit. I just, you know, I wasn't good at building models yet. One of my first ones, my very first model, which I'll probably post a video about that one. That's actually the one I did one of the best jobs on, and it was my first. And this one was probably, I think it was my third. Was it my third? Yeah, it was my third. I have a lot more models, but we'll get to that. Like I said, it was a good kit. Not a good beginner kit. Honestly, I don't think you should build any helicopters as a beginner. Especially when it comes to the propellers. They're always, you know? I would recommend this to an intermediate. I mean, I plan on going to buy the kit again and actually doing it the right way. Biggest tip I can give about building models, you gotta take your time, honestly. If you want it to look nice and you don't want to have to modify it into a crashed helicopter, then take your time. I mean, the paint job was pretty raw. But, yeah. Alright.